Good morning. It is day two of our third 30-day challenge, and it is meditation day because we've decided we're keeping meditation Sundays in. And let's hope that it's quiet. We shall see. We decided to do it indoors today because it is super cold and it's slightly raining outside, so we've decided to keep it nice and warm and toasty indoors.
It's tea, and we're ready to center ourselves and do some wonderful breathing. Hope you join us.
Okay, Babas, go sit down. Mama. Go sit down. Steven, go sit down. Stop.
No, blanket is wrong.
Oh, go get it. Girl, honey, you say bad girl. I'm a girl.
You bad boy.
Okay, I'm a bad boy. I'm a bad boy.
You're a bad boy.
I'm a bad boy.
You're a bad boy.
You can begin by taking a seat and getting comfortable. And when you're ready, just close your eyes. Now is a great time to check in with your body, looking for any tension that you might be holding on to. Oftentimes, this can hide as tightness in the jaw or tense shoulders. Just go ahead and relax and loosen those tight areas, wherever they appear. Now that you're ready to settle in, let's begin by taking a few slow, deep breaths. Inhaling through the nose and out through the mouth. As you finish your next deep breath, allow yourself to return to your natural breathing rhythm, just in and out through the nose. Now go ahead and shift your attention down to your heart. A great way to sense this or to feel it is to place one or both of your hands directly over your heart. You can keep your hands here for a few minutes or for the entire session. It's entirely up to you. And as you're focusing on the heart, now is a great time to send feelings of gratitude toward it, thanking it for all the years of effort and hard work it's done. Part of this practice is to express love inward, toward ourselves. To do this, you're going to repeat three phrases over and over, silently in your head. The phrases are, may I be happy, may I be healthy, and may I be at peace. For some, this can be difficult, because there might be aspects of our bodies or minds we dislike. It's important to remember that this isn't pleading or begging for these things, but rather wishing yourself well and presenting these as gifts to yourself. As you repeat these phrases, remember to gather all your attention and love behind one phrase at a time. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be at peace. You can repeat these choosing a frequency and rhythm that's pleasing to you. And if your attention wanders, just slowly bring it back to your phrases. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be at peace.
Go potty, honey.
And one last time, with love, let these words reach out from your heart into every cell of your body. May I be happy. May I be healthy.
Mommy, I'm peeing.
May I be at peace.
Good job, sweetheart.
Now call to mind someone that you care about. Someone that puts a smile on your face when you think about them. Or if you prefer, this can be someone you've never met, but they inspire you from a distance. When someone like this comes to mind, Just bring them here with you by creating a picture of them in your mind. Now, silently repeat these phrases of loving kindness to them. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be at peace. Feel your love and admiration for them. Feel that, like you, this person also deserves to be loved and at peace. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be at peace.
Do corpse pose for the rest of the time.
Now, take a moment to think of an acquaintance you have neutral or at times even mildly difficult feelings towards. Feel that you and this person are alike, maybe not in beliefs or mindset, but you're both beings that deserve to be loved. Opening up your heart and repeat. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be at peace. this is someone that's difficult for you to love, that's okay. Seeing if it's possible to soften or let go of feelings of resentment and dislike. Remembering that this is also someone who feels pain, anxiety, and suffering. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be at peace. And finally, expand your heart to encompass all beings everywhere. All the creatures on this planet, near and far, known and unknown, feeling compassion for the millions of beings that currently need love. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you be at peace. Now, as the meditation comes to a close, in your own time, slowly open your eyes. See if you can take this spirit and feeling of loving kindness for yourself and others with you throughout your day.
Did you fall asleep?
No, I didn't. I wanted to, though.
This one's really, really cool. This is the second time I've done this one with you. And the first time I did it.
It's really hard, though, when he tells you to give self-love to someone that you're not getting along with. That's really hard. I was able to do it, though. But that was really hard.
I had to work through some mental stuff on that one. That was different than the shorter version of
this. Yeah, the shorter version doesn't have that
part. That was surprising. Yeah, that's hard. But it took me a little time, but I think I did kind of clear some stuff out of my head.
Yeah, I did as well.
I kind of was envisioning it like a mason jar full of murky, muddy water with feelings. And I kind of visualized it as it's like the liquid's like clearing itself
out. Through a filter
until it's pure, those thoughts. And that's kind of how I had to visualize it. Because once it was this clear thing of water and I didn't have any, you know, bad feelings anymore, it's definitely hard. Like, yeah. I could see having to do that a few times, though.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah, things haven't fixed. There's nothing fixed, but I definitely feel better about it.
Feel lighter.
Yeah, it definitely helped. Definitely felt like a burden has slowly lifted.
Mm-hmm.
It's not completely gone, but it's definitely helped. I feel
that
like...
part took me some time.
Oh yeah,
to battle through.
It's probably why they put it in the longer one, because it needs
a little more time.
A little more time, yeah.
Well, I guess we all have people we don't get along with, or people that we feel have done us wrong that we need to let go of, so it doesn't cripple us now in the present.
Yeah, because it doesn't hurt them, it only hurts us.
But that was hard.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed this one, and I think I definitely want to do it a few more times.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
And I'm going to use your pose next time, because
my
sitting, my legs
started to go numb.
My legs got a little numb, and then my back hurt.
Yeah,
so.
And I was like, ooh. Because I think if you see me in the video, I'm like, trying to like work some stuff out. I'm like, yeah, no, I give up. I was like, I'm gonna lay down.
So I'm gonna think we should try corpse pose together next time.
Yeah, I like it.
I suggest it anyway because you're not crossing anything and your blood can flow
freely.
And then if your heart is level with all of your veins, your heart doesn't have to work that hard, so you can work on like cleansing those feelings. So I'm gonna be doing corpse pose next time we try that one.
Cooper.
Well, thank you for joining us.
Yes, thank you on day two of our third 30 days.
I have to say, I'm already feeling a million times excited about the yoga because I got through it really well. Not that it was too easy, but that I needed to really focus on doing them right. And I felt like my wrists weren't as angry. I mean, the downward dog is hard, but it's this kind of an angle is not as bad as some of the kind of more extreme, putting all your weight on it bent in a weird way. So I'm feeling real positive about the meditation and the yoga. How about you?
I'm pretty excited about it. I'm considering, as you saw, I did extra variations because I want to progress.
Yeah.
And I'm just very, very excited about our upper body and our abdominal workout that we get to do tomorrow.
Yes.
So I'm pretty, pretty stoked about it.
I am too. I actually really miss doing ab work, if that's even possible, but
well,
I missed the definition that I was getting from doing the twisties and the bicycle, so I'm looking forward to jumping in tomorrow. Okay, everyone, we'll catch you tomorrow on Tupin,
or not Tupin.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.